Have you ever had an idea and thought to yourself, that's so crazy, it just might work? Maybe, just maybe, you're the one who's gonna come up with the next big idea. And this morning, we're talking about inventions, those great ideas that just didn't go anywhere because you didn't know how to build it or how to sell it. And here to help us turn ideas into reality is George Davison. He's been called the Henry Ford of inventing. He's also helped people like Sharon Jones grow her idea from concept to product sample. And from there, people like Katie Brewer get it on store shelves. They're here to explain how together they made it all happen and how you too can make it happen. Good morning, everybody. Thank you for joining me.
Good morning,
Thanks
Christy.
For having us.
I'm thrilled to be doing this segment with y'all because this is a lot of fun. Now, talk to me about the Davison inventing method. What exactly is that?
Well, I'm an inventor, and I reinvented the method of how you invent in this country. And so years ago, I was just working on my own ideas, and one thing led to another, and I started to discover there's actually a process here that you can follow to get the product ready for market. And today, we're the largest invention factory in the country. We roll out 8 to 10 brand new inventions a day,
wow.
4 days a week. So, yeah, we're in full production. We design, engineer, build, package, and then present all these brand new product samples to industry.
And you actually helped someone like Sharon Jones. She's outside our studios this morning. She is very happy today because she had an idea and it came to fruition. Sharon, tell me about your idea.
I have invented a cool cot house. And this basically was invented for dogs and cats so that when they're outside, they can be in a nice cool dog house. We have the top that comes up and it's got a mesh vent, and down here the floor is vented with mesh, and as you can see the dog really enjoys the house. It is also 4 inches off the ground so that airflow can come underneath and come from the top, and so they stay cool. When it rains you put the flap over and they stay dry.
Awesome. Now, how did you come up with it?
Dog houses themselves, they're so hot inside. And as you'll notice, they never actually stay in the doghouse. They're always outside and digging holes so that they can be on the cool ground. Well, this is going to eliminate the dog digging. And they are nice and cool in the doghouse.
Boy, I'm loving this, especially here in South Florida where it gets really hot in the summertime. Sharon, one more question. How did George Davison help you out?
He took my idea, which I had on paper, a little drawing and an explanation, and they took it from idea into production into sales. And now this is all over in the stores.
They ran with it and she's a happy girl today. Now, George, tell me, how do you know? I mean, you must get so many ideas. How do you know which one's the winner?
Well, you know, that's a good question. I don't know which ones are going to be the winners coming in next. Sharon's not the typical person out there. I mean, where does the next Billy Bass, the flapping fish on the wall, come from?
I got one.
You know, so, or those little wrist bracelets the kids are wearing today.
Mm-hmm.
These ideas, everybody seems to have ideas. And yet the method of how to get that idea from in the mind and into a product sample so you can take it to the market or to a company like Katie's in this case, that's the challenge, and that's what we do.
Exactly. And when you develop the product, what's the next step after that?
Well, we design, engineer, build it, package it, and then we'll go off to a company and we'll present the physical product sample to them. And in this case, it's a pet product, as you can see. So we then went over to Katie's company, which is Hugs Pet Products, and we said, hey, this looks like it might be good for your company. What do you think?
So Katie, he comes to you, you look at the cool cot house. What happens after that?
Well, kind of our role is they bring us the finished product. We look at it and we say, wow, this thing could have some life.
It has to have
somewhere.
A wow, right?
Yeah, you gotta have the wow factor. And so what we did was we took it to trade shows. Our job is we manufacture it and sell it.
So no doubt the Davison method is really crucial to your business, right?
Oh, yeah.
In what way?
Well, it gives us a channel for new, fresh products. Our customers, our retailers, look for that. They want to see the new next thing. You know, that thing that they go, wow, that's a great idea. They want the tried and true, but they want some new stuff. That's where Davison comes in. They bring us new stuff, you know, that we can continue to be filtering out there in the market. Helps our business.
All right, don't go anywhere, because we're going to come back in just a couple minutes and talk more about inventions. I'm loving this. I even have an idea I'm going to tell you guys. And for you at home, this is where you and your ideas come in as well. If you have a great idea, up next, we're going to explain in more detail how you can move from your head into the marketplace. And Sharon's going to come inside and join us on the set to tell us all about how great it feels to get that first royalties check. Moolah coming into the bank. Love that. Stay with us. Welcome back, everyone. Before the break, we were talking about inventions, those great ideas you have in your head, but never quite knew how to turn them into products and into dollars. Well, it may be a whole lot easier than you ever thought with the right team behind you. Back with us is George Davison, the man behind the Davison Inventing Method, and Katie Brewer. She joins us again from Hugs Pet Products, and Sharon Jones. She's come inside to talk with us more. Thank you for joining us inside.
Thank you for having me.
Welcome back, you two.
Thanks.
All right, so
thank you.
Tell me, this must have been an amazing experience for you.
Oh my goodness, it has been phenomenal.
Totally phenomenal. Did you ever think it would come to this?
Oh no. Oh
never.
No.
Just an idea and turns into a big winner.
A big winner, yes.
I'm loving it. Now, George, tell me, for someone out there maybe who thinks they have, you know, a winning idea, what would you say?
Well, I'd say you need to gather your thoughts like Sharon did. Okay. And start to say, hey, do I really want to do something with this idea? And if you do, give us a call. I mean, that's how it works. I mean, all inventors need a procedure and process to go through. And but Sharon, she had enough inner strength to say, hey, I want to go do something with this. And I'd say that's a big part of this. Huge. So we act as the developers, but also as a positive support system around the creator of the idea. And I think that's real important when you're out there in your own world of creation. Sometimes, you know, Uncle Joe may not be so positive. So stay away from Uncle Joe sometimes, you know, and you need the positive people. That's what makes things happen in the world.
Now, if someone has an idea, should they patent it before they come to you?
I'd say that's, you have it backwards.
Okay.
The cart before the horse is how I describe that.
Okay.
When you have an idea and it's in its infancy, it hasn't been designed, engineered, built, tested, or anything yet, you don't patent it. What you want to get, you want to get through all the development sequences and then use basic confidentiality relationships to get all the way through the pipe. Otherwise, you're going to end up paying several times to get patent work done.
Absolutely.
So we don't do that.
All right, so let's kind of like wrap it up in full circle here, and let's talk about from beginning to end. We have idea, concept, completion, to store shelves. Wrap it up in kind of like bullet points for someone out there that maybe says, hey, I want to do this.
All right. So you have an idea, like okay. Sharon, with her pet product. You come into us. We design, engineer, build it, package it, get it all ready for industry. And then we present it in a finished format, like it's already sitting on the store shelves, to someone like Katie at her company.
And then Katie, you?
Mm-hmm. Well, it's crucial for us because by the time we get the idea from Davison, it is complete. Mm-hmm. It's no longer on a cocktail napkin somewhere. You know, it's complete. It's ready for us to really look at and say, hey, wow, does this have that wow factor? And then we can go on and show it and hopefully sell a ton of them and get them in stores.
And Sharon, I have to end with you, because you had the wow factor. You had the amazing idea, the cool cot house, which
yes.
Super cool. Tell me the day you got that first check. I heard it was pretty emotional for you. Walk me through it.
It was pretty emotional. They flew me out to Pittsburgh to the company and threw me a pretty big party.
Yeah.
And here he comes out with his big Ed McMahon-sized check. And I'm just blown away.
Oh, my gosh.
They had a cake, they had champagne and all this stuff, and I felt like a queen for the day. They were awesome.
Well-deserved, well-deserved. Sharon, again, thank you for being with us. It's been so much fun. Continue success with that next idea.
Thank you.
George, great idea, great company. Thank you so much for being here this morning. And
thank
Katie,
you,
thanks for joining us as well.
Thanks.
I had a lot of fun with you guys. We also want to thank the Florida Humane Society for providing Ducky the dog, who obviously loved the cool cot house. And for our viewers, if you want more information about taking your idea and making it business worthy using the Davison Inventing Method, just check out their website, davison.com.